Rejection hurts, doesn't it? It can discourage us, even stop us right in our tracks. Jesus knows the feeling. This Sunday, we read in the Gospel of Mark how Jesus goes to his hometown. And as he does on the Sabbath, he goes to the synagogue and teaches. And those who are there are amazed at his wisdom and his deeds of power. But the people who have known Jesus since he was a boy just can't believe that the carpenter's son is someone to listen to. They can't accept Jesus as a prophet of God. There's just too much history with him and with his family. They just can't hear a prophetic word from little Jesus, even all grown up, and they are offended by him. Jesus seems to understand their rejection as he quotes a proverb about how a prophet does have honor, just not in their hometown or among their kin. But Jesus is still amazed at their unbelief. I can imagine that Jesus' feelings are hurt and that he's feeling discouraged at their unwillingness to accept his deeds of power. And perhaps that's why he instructs the disciples the way he does. Not only does Jesus call and empower them to go and heal and teach and to cast out demons with authority, he also teaches them how to deal with rejection. You see, first, he instructs them to take less than what they need to live. No bread, no bag, no money, not even two shirts. It might seem like Jesus is setting the disciples up for failure, and yet what I hear Jesus teaching the disciples and us is that the kingdom of God is about supporting one another. It's about welcoming and providing for all in need. The kingdom of God is about community and mutuality, and all who follow Jesus are called to embody that in their very way of life. You see, the kingdom of God is about interdependence, and that's something our culture of independence does not readily teach. So maybe all the more we need to hear Jesus' advice to the disciples for those times when they are unwelcomed or rejected, the advice to shake it off and keep going. That is, don't let rejection in one place keep you from moving on to the next opportunity to share God's amazing, redeeming grace. Don't let rejection keep you from embodying the interdependence and care for one another that Jesus is teaching. Don't let rejection keep you from proclaiming the good news of God's love in Jesus Christ. Because while rejection might be a part of discipleship, it can't stop the kingdom of God. I look forward to seeing you in worship.